Now, D Block Europe are recognized as a trio consisting of Young Adz, Dirtbike LB, and Lil Pino, although most commonly in their tracks they are only focused between Young Adz and Dirtbike LB, with Lil Pino only ever being featured on a song every 6 to 8 months. So being within such a successful trio such as D Block Europe, people are always going to draw comparisons between the artists within that group. This usually ending up with one of the members of the group being considered the most talented or receiving the most credit for the success of the group. We have seen this happen with YOFB, for example, where although Band OK and Double L's are releasing some major hits right now and have been ever since SJ got locked up, SJ has been considered the most talented out of the three for a long time now, and he's almost been missing from the scene for about 2 years. We've also seen this happen between 3-8 and Owls, where although they have now split, 3-8 was always held in that high regard and held their tracks together as he was the hitmaker. And now we are seeing this with Young Adz being the full D Block Europe big hitter, while Dirtbike LB is kind of overlooked. But obviously, Young Adz and Dirtbike LB have been considered a duo for a long time now, with the two coming together after meeting in year 7. Now, for any of you that don't know, back in 2013, after Young Adz came out of his first ever record deal with Universal, Young Adz was picked up and then managed by the older brother of future D Block Europe member, Dirtbike LB. And with the older brother of Dirtbike LB having that connection with Jadakiss over in America, well, this is where it all started to go uphill for Young Adz, as he then was featured on the 2015 Jadakiss album, Top 5 Dead or Alive. And the reason this is so relevant in this conversation is that with Young Adz earning that introduction to the American scene through his connection with Dirtbike LB, and then through Dirtbike LB getting the attention from his older brother, who then gave Young Adz the name in the States. And so, does Young Adz have a lot to repay Dirtbike LB for, as he helped him get to that level? Because clearly, although Young Adz definitely has the talent to back it up, this is a who you know, not what you know type of situation. So with this topic already being brought up multiple times now, I sort of just wanted to have my take on things and decide whether or not Young Adz should go solo for the sake of his music career. Now, of course, Young Adz has been solo before. He was the guy that impressed Jadakiss in the first place. He was the guy who got signed to his first music label at the age of 13. He was the guy who actually recruited Dirtbike LB into the D Block Europe circle in the first place. And with Young Adz set to release a project this year on his own, would cutting ties with Dirtbike LB and even Lil Pino help Young Adz in the long run, as the two or three would no longer be seen as the package deal? Or is a combination of Young Adz and Dirtbike on a track really what makes DBE click? And one thing you have to remember is that these two came up together and have been on the rise for a long time now and keep improving year on year. And ever since they first dropped Trap House, that was their first ever hit that really helped put D Block Europe on the map. This was done together and you can't deny that. So when comparing Young Adz and Dirtbike LB, there are some major differences, whether it is in their verses or their hooks. One thing cannot be denied, and that is that Young Adz is just a hook-making machine, with that being the major theme in D Block Europe's music since the beginning. When Young Adz has a strong performance, so does the song, and vice versa, because whatever comes out of the song, whether it be a hit or not, Young Adz was the one to make it or break it. And this is because 90% of the time, Adz is the one who consistently brings the wavy, melodic sound to their music. And that is usually what makes the DBE sound so memorable and easy to vibe to.
King up in that kitchen, I don't need no apron. Every other week I was catching cases. Put that blade to that white, no, I ain't no racist. You my lady and I need you, pull up in that spaceship. Yeah, yeah, that girl amazing. Look at her.
Or you can even look at one of the more recent examples from D Block Europe's last album, on the track Birds Are Chirping, where Young Adz lays down some clean, clean vocals and shows everyone what makes him such an icon.
My mother told me, watch the people that you move around. My new car on order looking like a cruise ship. I robbed a couple niggas that I went to school with. Whipping up in the kitchen, they look like cool whip. This year seen a couple dramas, no problems tonight, I'm feeling clean. She said her boyfriend is...
But one thing I have figured out whilst listening to D-Block Europe is that Young Adz has a lot more confidence in his sound. And when he is creating that and how he wants to portray himself, he is much more successful than Dirt Bike LB is. I mean, Young Adz from such a young age has always had that superstar element to him and his sound, as no one was doing what he was doing from the beginning. Whenever he is on a hook or even delivering a verse, Young Adz sounds way more comfortable on the beat than LB does. And that is just my opinion. And I think this is because not only has Young Adz had more time to perfect his craft, he is just more versatile, with more in his locker than LB. Like, Young Adz is set to release a project later this year where no autotune is on it. And, well, could you see Dirt Bike LB doing this? In my humble opinion, I don't think so. So, of course, Young Adz does have that natural talent in his singing voice that is seen a lot more in his earlier music that does end up blowing Dirt Bike LB out of the water, which is one of the reasons as to why I do prefer Young Adz over Dirt Bike LB. But I just can't deny that Dirt Bike LB does add to D-Block Europe's songs. And of course, he doesn't have the same smooth delivery of a Young Adz, but he undeniably brings a different energy to every song that he is on. And although LB doesn't switch it up too much, when he does, it's clear to see that he brings something else to the table, whether that be with an authentic original flow, or his own style to the autotune wave.
Scars all over my body like I went to war with the devil himself. I have a nigga, put one in your head up, your neighbors say get in some hell. Hard to be focused and righteous when you feel like you're living in hell. Spot a brick on the scales.
Also, something I've noticed about where Dirt Bike LB is usually placed in the majority of DBE songs is that his verse usually comes in around 3/4 of the way through the track, with the verse only ever lasting 20 to 30 seconds. And this is why I believe this debate is something that has been brought up before, because not only does this make Dirt Bike LB so much less memorable, it shows that with or without a dirt bike feature in there, it doesn't really make that much of a difference to the song, as you could call LB a less talented version of Adz. But I don't really think about it this way, because Dirt Bike LB is a part of D-Block Europe. He is a part of the image. He is a part of the creation of the brand. Importantly, alongside Young Adz. Because what is D-Block Europe without the brand it is created? Actually, not that much. So yeah, in my opinion, I don't think Young Adz should go solo, because ever since the start, it has been the two. And of course, with the success they're having right now, if it's not broke, don't fix it. It's very obvious that Young Adz is the star of the group. And to be honest, although that is something you have to consider, Young Adz still has loyalties to Dirt Bike LB, because they came up together and broke through again together. And with Young Adz already having announced that a solo project this year is set to be released, this seems like he is acknowledging the demand for a project that only includes him. He kind of did this early last year too, when he was part of the trio that released Insomnia alongside Skepta and Chip. And this will only build a stronger brand for Young Adz in the long run. And I think Dirt Bike LB should do the same, as taking a step back from D-Block Europe could do wonders for his sound and help distinguish himself in the industry. And then, when they come back together as a collective, this surely can only improve D-Block Europe and their future music. But anyway, that's the way I see it. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Should Young Adz be solo for good, or should he continue the D-Block Europe brand for years to come? And as always, make sure you've subscribed to this channel. You've been listening to The Noise Complaint, and I'm out.